Since I'm in a Limp Bizkit mood tonight, I'm going to be showing you how to play hot dog off of chocolate starfish and hot dog flavored water. Once again, just a really tight song. The groove in it is just really good. And another great guitar riff by Wes Borland, one of my personal favorites. And I think that guy is way underrated. I think he's great. Check him out in Black Light Burns, too. He's has some good shit in there. Anyway, I'll jump right in. The tuning is Limp Bizkit tuning, so it's E, B, F sharp, C sharp. Same thing as in the Break Stuff video. The song's a little bit more tricky, not too much, but I'll just get right into it. The only thing is, you guys have to bear with me, when he does it on the record, he's using a dive bar, and I don't have a dive bar on my guitar, but I will tell you where it's supposed to go. Every time you hear E in the song, like, for the main riff, that boom, 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 those booms are just open E's, but he's just hitting the dive bar, so he's hitting it, and he's going vroom, and he's dropping it down. So if you want to get that sound, you can. Personally, I don't use one. If you play it, you can get away with it. It's not that big of a deal. But start right in. It's... And what he's doing is he's using octaves, similar to In the Beautiful People. I went over that. And what he's doing is open E, and then he's hitting this octave, the 7 on the B sharp. I meant not B sharp, F sharp. So the second string. And then 9 on the E. At the same time, just like a power chord. So it'd look like... So it goes... And what he does is he just moves 1 over. So instead of 7 and 10, he does 8 and 10. And at 7 and 9, he does 8 and 10. So he goes. And then that, after the riff, he just does, you know, scraping. So it's... The way I do it, just to give it a little bit more, so it sounds like the dive bar, is just you take it and you go... And that's all I'm doing is instead of going, I'm sliding up. So I'll just slide one position over. So. And that's basically the main riff. On to the verse part, after the here we go, here we go. It's a little bit more tricky, and I'm going to show you how to do it. I'm going to play it first. And it's kind of hard to tell because he's using an effect in that song. But the way you play it is just 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2. It's just regular. Just play it. It'll sound, it'll synchronize with the song if you're trying to play along with, once again, the studio version. But what he's doing is he's starting at a 12 on the C sharp. And he's going 12. And then on the F sharp... 14, and then on the B, he's going 12, and then he goes back on the F sharp to 14, and then back on C sharp, 15, and then back on F sharp, 17, and then B, 15, and then go to 14, so that part looks like this, and then he slides down here, and he hits a 5, 5th fret on C sharp, and then kind of a stretch, he goes to the 9 on the F sharp, and then a 7, on B, and then 10 on B sharp, and at C sharp, and then 12 on B sharp, then 10 again on B, and then 9 on B. So what that looks like is, now that part once again all together looks like, and that goes along until the hey, this song. Everybody knows this song. And all that is, so it's hey, it's quick mutes, just open on the B, on the C sharp, sorry. And then it's a, you're tremolo picking 12, 13, and 11, so it's a, really fast. I might not have the beat correct how I'm doing it right now, but if you listen to the song, you'll get the beat. Just know that the fretting is dun-dun, dun-dun, dun-dun-dun-dun. Tremolo pick 12 fret, 12th fret to the 13 to 11 on F sharp. So it goes. And then it goes back to the chorus, which is, you wanna fuck me like an animal, which is just back to the, you know, the main riff throughout the whole song. And then it goes to the bridge, which is the hey, listen up, baby. And all that is, you know, do a E minor chord, which is open, 2, 2, on the first bottom three, open, 2, 2, so it's, and what he's doing is a 6 on the B, on the bottom string there, so he's going, and once again, I'm not doing it with the beat because I don't have the song playing, but, once again, I'm sorry, you guys can match all that up with the song as you're playing, or if you know it. And the other part that I need to tell you is the kiss my star fish, and it's basically just using that octave I showed you earlier, which is the one you use for the main riff, and it's kiss my star fish my, but at the other part it goes, and what he's doing is he's hitting that octave, boom, kiss, boom, my, star, fish, my. So on the off parts that he's doing there, he's going that octave, and then he's doing another power chord down here, but you're not doing an octave, so you're doing on the C sharp, you're doing 6, and then 8 on the F sharp. So quick 2, 1, so hit it twice quickly, and then do an open, and then back to that. So it's, So you get that sound. And then basically, that's it. Those are the main parts throughout the whole song. Once again, let me know if you need any help with it. Let me clarify a few things. I'm getting back into the groove of this. And I apologize for the naming the strings throughout the whole thing. Once again, hopefully you guys like it, and let me know what you think.